house. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. And here we stand, two remain. Cain, the once darling of Northernlion's Let's Play The Binding of Isaac, and Blue Baby, who has always been the redheaded stepchild, but came dangerously close to winning the race to defeat Satan. But you know what? Fair play. Let's go with Cain this time. See if give him another chance. If I beat Satan as him, I will have beaten it as every character in the game, except for Blue Baby. There's only two remaining. Hey, tears up right off the bat. That almost makes up for wasting my key right there, trying to go to the... or going to the shop by accident. Well, we might as well see what they have on tap here. They have Mr. Boom, I believe is that item, as well as a 5-cent bomb. Unfortunately, I don't have enough to get either of that right now. Oh, there's the item room right down there. Please be some kind of money item. Range up is a terrible item to start with, but I guess I did get tears up as well. Continue exploring here. It's a serious shame I wasted that bomb, that key. Although there's nothing here yet that I could have used it on. Still, you know, it's just knowing that I made such a stupid mistake. It hurts, man. It really burns. If I could get some bombs, though, I could be persuaded to forget about my mistakes. Eh, there's a key, anyway. But I need the bomb so that I can go back to that tinted rock. Well, now with 5 cents, I could go to the shop, and I could buy a bomb. But if only I only get 2 more cents, just 2 more cents, I could get enough money to buy Mr. Boom. That is not quite good enough! Let's fight the boss. Maybe it's Larry Jr., and if it is Larry Jr., his poop will drop money sometimes. Alright, well, we know we're getting a cube of meat out of this anyway. We'll just take down Famine. We'll get our first cube of meat, which again, could come in handy, depending on whether or not I can upgrade to a full Meat Boy. But I don't like having Meat Boy that much anymore. He used to be my go-to, my ultimate strategy for beating the game, or at least not a strategy so much, since it was entirely luck-based whether or not I got him. Wow, bad luck I'm getting hit so far. Bad skill, really, I'm getting hit so far. Oh lord, I'm getting scissor attacked. This is a bad start. Okay, take him out here. Make a run for it. Please drop 1.5 hearts when you die, as well as a single penny. Just a single penny, that's all I need, man. One heart, a cube of meat. Ugh, well. Okay, let's go buy the bomb. Maybe there'll be like 2 nickels inside of the spirit heart. Or inside of this tinted rock. Probably just spirit hearts, but hey, we'll see. Hey, we got a spirit heart and the rock. That's actually really worthwhile. Now we're doing increased damage. Still not super happy with the way things have gone so far over the course of this video, but I've got range up, tears up, and damage up, so I am a little bit more offensively potent. I need some bombs and keys, though, or this is going to be over quickly. Either that or it's going to be a long grinding down process. Let's murder all this fire. Nothing at all. Ah, we're going to take out Sloth. Oh, up! Oh, oh. That's okay. Sloth tends to be one of the easier 7 deadly sins to fight. Well, mid-range, I would say. Lust is probably a little bit easier. Wrath is a little bit easier, although Wrath takes fucking forever. Gluttony's, I've already forgotten which one that is. It's one of my favorite to fight, though. Now, remember, the Empress gives us the curse. That was Sloth, now I remember. So, with the curse, or the Whore of Babylon curse, I should say, not just the curse, we can do increased damage for a room, so I'll probably save that and use that on the boss now. Gotta be careful in this room. Just hang out, take one down at a time. Good. Could probably shoot that guy diagonally, but more trouble than it's worth, in all likelihood. Tarot card, something good. Wheel of Fortune. Might end up using that, actually. Never know, maybe I can get some bombs or keys out of that slot machine with the 2 cents that I have right now. Lord knows I won't be buying anything else from the shop for a little while, at least. But we will go to the item room, of course, because why not? Secret room, please. Hey, I'm gonna get this... Oh, no, I can't get him anywhere. He would unlock the secret room. Bombs? Well, money. And 1/2 a heart, I'm back to full health. And another chest. What do we have here? Pill, health up, please. Telepills. Well, thanks for wasting my bloody time. Just wanted to meander my way over to that item room, but I guess that's not allowed, is it? Edmund McMillan. Fucking telepills. And of course, I will never unlock the I Am Arrow room. What do we have here in the item room? Spelunker! So now we can see through doors, which basically means we can find the secret room without having to waste our bombs, which is good. I'm not sure if we can actually walk through. We can't. We need a bomb to be able to walk into the room, unfortunately. With X-ray goggles, you don't. But, hey, that's alright. Now I'm not going to waste any bombs, which is good, because I don't seem to be getting very many either. What's this one? Justice! Yes, please! Bomb and key. Useful immediately. So, we will go to the secret room and hope for an unbelievable sum of money. 6 cents. Well, it's not bad. Could be better. Could be worse. I'm not going to use my Wheel of Fortune because I want to hold on to my money to potentially buy something from the next floor. No bombs, so I can't do anything with this room. We will basically abandon this Wheel of Fortune card because I don't have any bombs with which to blow it up either. So, to pick up the Empress, probably use it on this boss fight, depending on who we get. Larry Jr. Champion Larry Jr., why not? Increased damage should make this a relatively short fight. Not as short as the fight is when you use Brimstone, but shorter than it has been in the past. Let's just put it that way. More of these. My shots are so slow, it's actually a good thing, because they seem to kind of float over and just destroy Larry Jr. Hey, he dropped a Spirit Art, and we got an HP up. Pretty good. Possible deal with the devil here. Ooh, the quarter for 3 Spirit Hearts. Nah, let's just go down. I've been taking a lot of stupid damage so far, so I want to kind of keep myself... I want to have as much defensive leeway as possible. Let's put it that way. Take these guys out one at a time. It's the safest way to travel. Pick up an extra key. It's good. We can go to the shop and the item room on this floor. I'm really determined to make this the Cain run. So more passives, please. The shears, actually, that's much better than a passive. This is one of the best items in the game. Spawns that level 5 Meat Boy-esque creature that basically just tears ass. We're not going to use it right now. We'll save it for the boss. I'm not sure if I'd be able to recharge it before the boss if we use it right now. Stupid damage on my part again. But hey, shit happens, right? If we can kill those bomb flies as soon as they spawn, well then, 1 Spirit Heart's not a huge price to pay. More than I should have to pay, but not a huge price. What do we got going on here in the shop? Book of Revelations, Spirit Hearts, Keys, and Pills. Book of Revelations is tempting. I mean, Shears is great too. It's a quality problem to have. Too many good items. Oh, okay, gotta be careful. Dodge the shots. There we go. Room wasn't so bad after all. I was really hoping there'd be some kind of like 10 bomb item in there. No such luck, unfortunately. That's okay, this is decent right now. I like having increased base damage. It makes everything in the game a whole lot fucking easier. This is a shitty layout, though. I hate dealing with this room. Because it seems like you spend most of your time just dodging the flies. You get very little opportunity to actually shoot them. It's only when they're in one of those, like, 2 or 3 lanes where you can actually get to them. Takes a while, but it works. Yeah, we'll deal with this. You got a pill out of it. I won't take the pill just yet, because I gotta make sure I take out these silkworms first. Let's put myself in a corner here and then use it. Bad gas. What a waste. There should be a pill identifier. Like, you can get a PhD. There should be like a pharmacist item that you can get that identifies pills before you use them. It wouldn't be that useful, but it'd be an okay passive. It might save you a couple of hearts in the long run. But, you know, there probably won't be any more DLC for this game. Again, considering it's a $5 game, and we've already gotten 1 substantial free update. Okay, gotta be careful. There's gonna be a lot of shots flying here. That's okay. Continue to strafe around. And one more. There we go. 3 keys. We can make some progress now. We got a little bit of key insurance for our next few floors. Secret room is somewhere in here. I can't really see right now because I'm focusing on taking out these maggots. But I know. There it is. Okay. We'll just use a bomb over there. 1 bomb. Fair price to pay. Hey, we got the shovel. Ooh. Unfortunately, the shovel is actually kind of not a good item because you miss out on whatever upgrade you might get from the boss. So I'm not going to bother with that, but I will fight whoever we've got in here. Oh, man. I think Lust might actually be a little bit faster than me, but Lust can drop HP up, so it's worth fighting it. Usually it is worth fighting the mini-bosses, actually. Hey, Poison Touch, that's pretty good as well. Actually, I might have been talking out of my ass when I said that Lust can drop HP ups. I knew that it dropped some sort of passive, but I guess more likely that that passive was actually Poison Touch, and that's the only one she can drop. But hey, that's cool too. Poison Touch is pretty good. Now, I've got to decide whether I want to keep the Book of or whether I want to keep the Shears or go with the Book of Revelations. It's not going to be a problem, I guess, if I don't get any more money, but if I do get to 15 cents, that's a close call. I mean, I love the Book of Revelations. I know that I could use that to fight more Horsemen of the Apocalypse. Looks like it might not be an issue. Well, let's use the Shears just for the hangout. Meat Boy should be able to take out all the shit for me. I'll just pop out whenever I get a chance, do a little bit of extra damage. There's a champion Silkworm over there. I'll try not to take any stupid damage against that. Really, all damage right now is stupid damage, because I can just hang out in the corner. There we go. We got some sort of tarot card out of it. Oh! Yeah, that was close. Genuine Fear. God damn it. Magician gives us homing tears for a room. Oh, we're going to get a little Chad at the end of this fight, which is it's a good defensive item. Because we'll be able... Oh, there we go. That one's dead. We'll be able to... regenerate our health a little bit more quickly than usual. Let's just go down to the next floor. Lots of keys. We can go to the shop on the next floor. Hopefully pick up some kind of passive item. Something more immediately useful to me. But it does hurt abandoning the Book of Revelations. That's been my go-to item for so long. Since the start of the Let's Play, really. I think I might have used Book of Revelations on my first run through the game. There's a key. Oh, wow. Popped up in a useful spot, too. Bomb and key out of the same room. Half-decent luck. Oh, this is tricky. But I get a reward for completing this room. Let's go to the item room and hopefully get something useful. Not the shovel, I hope. Again, because like I really want the items. Like that's the key to success. It's not going through the game as fast as possible. It's getting the items so that you can complete the game more reliably. So our item here, I believe this is magnetic bombs. Yeah, homing bombs. Alright, that could be useful. More useful in conjunction with the fetus upgrade, but this will be useful on zombie rooms at the very least. Not a great item, not an upper tier item, but it's okay. Certainly something that I can make use of over the next few floors. Okay, we gotta watch out for this. There we go, now we can just focus on taking out this guy. And of course the secret room is in here. What do we have here? 3 cents! Dick move, game. But at least I didn't waste any extra bombs getting to it. Whoa! Came firing there. Yeah, we should kill that one. Got one more dead, this will be a cakewalk. Maybe. There we go. Please, keys and bombs. Hey, a nickel, that's actually much better than the things I asked for. And we got ourselves a tinted rock here. What do I even want out of that? Spirit hearts, I guess, are always useful. Gotta be careful, though. These things are gonna be coming up in my grill soon. Come on. Like, I hate this layout for that exact reason. I always seem to get trapped in the corner. But now we've opened up some lanes, at least, so I can more reliably do some damage. There we go. And with the silkworm dead, can hopefully get a couple spirit hearts here to replenish our stock. Well, a couple bombs, that's alright too. Although I took some needless damage on that room, I'm starting to feel like I could use some HP ups on the next floor. Oh man, what a waste. But luckily, poison damage will get to him. I'm gonna use a bomb here actually so I can get to this chest. And, well, maybe not. Maybe the bomb will just destroy Larry Jr. Because one of the downsides of having homing bombs. Oh no, it still worked. We got one more Larry Jr. section to deal with. Drops a lot of hearts on the completion of every room. I want to do some more exploring, though. I'm not finished yet. And again, we can pretty much use Shears to take out this boss without us being in risk, as long as there's a single rock on the room that we can just hang out next to. I hate dealing with these guys as early as the second room. Or, sorry, as early as the caves part 2. Like, those headless guys, they feel like an enemy that should only appear in the depths. They're not womb level, but certainly depths level. Rolling in bombs and keys now. It's fine by me. Just continue firing down the center here. There we go. A penny for my troubles. Definitely want to go to the shop on this floor. This could get something really useful. I'll use a bomb to go to this chest. Get the penny out of it as well, if nothing else. And a key. There's the... Oh, okay. Gotta remove one of these guys from power. There we go. Gotta remove one of these guys from power. Like I'm organizing a coup. Let's check out the next room here. Teleport! Not as useful as the shears. Not nearly as useful as the shears. There we go. We got the arcade, which I will probably avoid, as I usually do, even though it's ill-fated a lot of the time. Actually, we'll see. We'll see. I'll visit the shop first and see what's up. There's lots of hearts around, so I could abuse the blood bank for an HP up. But that takes so much time. Steam sale. Absolutely worth picking up. And now that everything's half price, why not buy that as well? And we'll blow up this. Maybe get some more spirit hearts. Two more, in fact. Looking up. With only 4 cents left, let's go check out this room. We'll play... What do I want? Pretty fly. No, I would rather have the poop helmet. But also, I want to win some hearts so we can play that blood bank a couple of times. Although, I suppose, actually, I will play the blood bank maybe 3 or 4 times anyway, because there's a bunch of hearts left over. Right, here we go. More money, please. Okay, we'll play the blood bank maybe 4 times. Whoa! Not necessary! That was quick. Explode you, explode you. I apologize for this. Got more bombs out of it, and actually more money as well. That worked out really well. Let's go explore this last room, and then we'll go fight the boss. Never know what you might find in there. Maybe some more tinted rocks. In fact, there is! Well, when the luck comes, it certainly comes all at once. Not to mention a champion silkworm that dropped a chest, containing a bomb which blew up almost all of my remaining enemies. And 2 more spirit arts. That, we might look back on that as the moment that really made this run possible. If I start, like, with all these spirit arts, inevitably, I'm gonna lose hearts. Example, you can see right there. But, if I get the opportunity to trade with the devil quickly, I can get rid of these spirit hearts, leverage them for something more useful. Ah, death card is way more useful than the magician. Leverage them for something more useful, i.e. a brimstone upgrade, or, I don't know, there's lots of potential upgrades, let's put it that way. And that, you know, I could parlay that into something fantastic. We'll see, though. Take it step by step. Ooh, baby. I want to get with you, girl. Fistula. And there are some rocks for me to hang out with. Or hang out over, I suppose. So I'll take some pot shots, but then we'll just let Meat Boy Deluxe here take care of it. With his slick pickup trucks. Ah, I took damage there. I didn't have my perspective right, I guess. Just use the death card. Alright, that made it easier. Got another HP up. Fine by me. Let's head down to the next floor. Doing well so far. Not absurdly overpowered. But well. Bomb and key to get here? Well, I'm rich in both. Who dares wins? Let's just waste a spirit heart by walking into the explosion of my own bomb. Like a goddamn idiot. Again, these guys. Total pains in the asses. That's okay. Once you get them down, as long as you can kind of maintain your distance, not too much of a problem. I wish I had this guy, though. He doesn't respect the Geneva Convention. There we go. What's our chest going to contain? Bombs and money. That's good. With 15 cents, I can make a splash in the store here. The shop, as I more frequently call it. This is a tricky room. Got to be on the watch out here. Most people say the lookout. I'm trying to bring the watch out back. Sounds like Victorian or something. And with this one, we'll move on. Get another bomb. More health that I don't need. Tinted rock over here. So I will. 2 more spirit hearts. And for another bomb and key, why not check out this chest? Tarot card, the world. That's a good card. Let's check it out. I feel like Steve Brule every time I say that. We got the world card, let's check it out. P.S. I don't do a very good Steve Brule impression. Well, yet another dick room like this, except we got bomb flies instead of the laser flies. I don't know why I call them laser flies. They don't really shoot lasers. It's more like a bead. The bead doesn't sound cool. Laser sounds cool. You never would find like an American gladiator named Bead. Hi, I'm Bead. I mixed whey protein with my granola. That joke could use some more time in the editing room. It needs to be punched up. And I am not the man to do it. Hey, we found the shop. And the mob trap room, which I will probably not go into. Well, maybe. I don't know. I'm pretty good on bombs and keys. and spirit arts, actually, even though I have taken a plethora of stupid damage here. Check out what we got here. Well, compass is going to prove useful, always. It'll show us everything. I mean, we already know where everything is here. The dog item, I've forgotten what it does. I'm not sure it's worth 7 cents to look into that, but hey, let's pick it up. Damage up. Okay, well, that was good then. I was going to buy the spirit heart, but instead, let's get that. Maybe we can get the spirit heart for the penny in here. Well, no. Maybe one day. Damage up, always useful. Now if I could get brimstone, I'll be rolling on dubs. I don't know what that means. I am the whitest man on earth. Okay, there's the fetus is dead. Took long enough, but hey. Hoppers should not... One hit for hoppers! That sounds like an indie band. Hit for hoppers. And one more. I'll waste 3 bombs to take these guys out. I don't care. I don't care. I got damage up. More health that I can't use. I'm kind of looking for a penny so I can go back and buy that spirit. Oh god, that's a tough room. Shears? Dare I? Get away from me, you headless and neckless man. Or seriously, neck full man. Well, that's going to give us homing tears for a room. That's good because I abandoned our last variation on that. Or our last iteration of that. That's the word I'm looking for. Should be doing substantial damage now. Hey, there's our extra cent. Let's go buy the spirit hearts. Remember, I passed up that Book of Revelations, and that's like the one that got away, even though I let it get away. We're talking like it's a Nicholas Sparks novel or something, so I'm always trying to get back to that. So yes, give me that spirit heart. I'm out of money, but that's okay. Steam sale has already paid for itself. It's damage up. I love having good base damage. Makes everything so much easier. Really greases the wheels. Oh, fuck. Leaper room. Luckily, the leapers should go down relatively quickly as well. Not as quickly as the hoppers. Jesus, 3 of them jumping at once is a pain in the ass. Okay, well, 1 of them left. That's not a problem. Hopefully. Come on, get on the spikes! Yes. Well, we'll go to the secret room. We could have done that earlier, but why not do it now? Slot machine. Can't even use you, so I don't feel bad about exploding you. 2 cents and a key. I could clear out the shop, but I don't really need to. Let's go down here and fight whoever this mini-boss is. Ooh, I want more money. I'll be back, Judgment. Hopefully we fight... Can we even fight Greed in that room? I don't think we can. That's such a stupid set of damage to take right there. Just strafe directly into the bomb fly's explosion. Oh well. If we can fight Greed, we can get enough money to give a lot to Judgment. That's Gluttony. We can get some good stuff off Gluttony as well, if I remember correctly. Oh, actually hit him, please. Remember when I thought Gluttony was a hard mini-boss? Those were the days, man. Things were much quainter back then. One part of Isaac a day? What was I thinking? Well, we might as well give him 4 cents anyway. I got a lot of bombs. Could get some more bombs or keys out of it. Possible that he'll drop something quickly. Or not at all. Hey, there we go. We got a key out of it. It's paid for itself. Sorry, Dan. I might be back for you later. Use a bomb to get to that penny, but it's probably not worth it. Use my most advanced strafing techniques here. If I can kill them on the spikes, then that makes my job really easy. They just die. Doesn't get much easier than that. They only take 1 hit after they get to the ooze state now that I've got this increased damage. I don't need to tell you that that's awesome. What are we dealing with here in the item room? Hey, more damage up. I'll take it. What do we get out of this chest? Money would be nice, actually. Hey, a bomb. That's okay. Alright, so we're fighting, war this time. Took some dumbass damage, but that's okay. I will kind of contribute to this fight. And by contribute, I mean take, like, a buttload of stupid damage, I guess. But that's okay. I've got a good number of spirit hearts. We'll get our second cube of meat, and possibly be able to make a deal with the devil in here. Ouija board or increased damage. Actually, neither of those really appeal to me, to be honest with you. Let's head downstairs. Depths Part 2? We are on the Depths Part 2 already. Well, that was fast. Greed in the secret room. Well, that's good. I'd rather have greed in the secret room than greed in the shop. Greed in the secret room means I can still go to the shop. Since I have the steam sale, I'll be able to buy a lot because greed drops a lot of money. If, there we go, 4 cents. Not a lot of money, but could be worse. We're gonna move this way because this is where the item room and the boss room are. I do want to visit the shop as well, though. I'll probably explore everything on this floor. Can't get to that without the use of the shears. Oh, this is dead end. Okay. Dead end, dead end, dead end, dead end. Okay, Gluttony. Gotta pay attention constantly. They only take 2 shots each to kill with this setup that I got rolling now, though. Which is really good. Haven't had to use any of those hearts yet. Guts is not a problem. At all, actually. Particularly since it's very easy to stand in spots where we just cannot be hit at all. We'll get another cent out of that. And we'll continue moving to the right, because this is the direction of everything fun. Ah! I thought I could actually... There's a little hole for me to hide in there. Still rolling on spirit hearts, though, which is okay. Mom's pad is absolutely useless to me right now. Let's go back towards the shop-type area. I could probably afford to use my shears once before we fight Mom anyway. This is not the room to do it on. 2 keys? Let's try it. Ah! I don't need it. What a waste. Let's use the shears on this room and I'll just get the fuck out of there, basically. Better safe than sorry. Pick up a bomb. Oh man, if there's a battery in the shop, it's game over. For either me or the game. Probably me, but possibly the game. Another key. Where are all these keys coming from? I'm getting incredible drops. Really lucky. It was just good because I'm taking a dumb amount of damage so far. That's okay. Tarot card is going to be the chariot. More useful than the magician because this gives us the unicorn. Bell, back for more, I see. Well, I'll give you 5 cents. See if maybe I can secure the HP upgrade. Does some... Hey. Hey, thanks a lot. I just got a battery for a cent. What's going on in here? I need to get 3 more cents so that I can get that razor blade, just to see what it does. If not, I guess I'll buy a spirit heart and consider myself lucky for that, but I'm gonna do some exploring here because I really, really want to see what that razor blade does. It can't possibly be a passive, but because usually the items you get for beating the game are not passives. But it could be better than the shears, I guess. I don't know. We'll see. I'm already out of spirit hearts, too, so I'm starting to feel like I should pick some up. It's always nice to have that little extra, guarantee, basically. But there's not a lot of rooms left here. Oh, fuck! Let's use it. Okay. And from the mob trap room, we get... 10 bombs. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna use the shears. Say, get the fuck out of my way. Meat Boy's gonna take care of all this shit for me. Those 10 bombs could prove to be really useful as we get into the womb. And we want to blow up a bunch of regular rocks to see if they have spirit hearts inside of them. And the gamble will pay off as long as I can both recharge my shears and pick up some health. Sorry, and, I forget what I was going to say after that. And use these bombs, and get some spirit hearts, basically, is what I meant to say. Tammy's head. We could use that on, like, every single room, but now I need to recharge, so... Wish I could get to that chest. Suppose I could use shears to get to that chest, but... Gotta save him for the boss now. I'm gonna try something. First we'll blow it up. Then we'll put a bomb here and shoot it across. 2 keys. Yeah, we'll take the 1 key anyway. Traded 2 bombs for a single key. Not a good trade. But it also made me feel smart doing it. Strange how that works. Brain guy, yeah, please exit the premises. Things are about to get nasty. 3 cents, that's all I need, come on. Oh, stop. I hate the sound they make. That's the creepiest part of these guys. Oh, okay, there we go. Got him down. Shears are very nearly recharged. They will be after this room, in fact. There's a bomb. Could go back and buy the spirit heart, but I'm lazy. Use the shears right away, and then back the fuck up. Wow, we do a lot of base damage. I wish I had some kind of piercing shot, but still, look at how fast we're taking out Mom. In conjunction, me boy and myself. Taking names. Kicking ass, is it? And also a high priority. Certainly taking names here. That was a quick fight. Hey, and she dropped the spirit heart. Gave me some increased range, which is sometimes nice. And we'll head down to the next floor, where we will hopefully be able to find a bunch of spirit hearts. Otherwise, hey, there's a secret room. Otherwise, we're probably not going to last too long once we get down to Shoal. If we get down to Shoal. Sheol, whatever you call it. I'm not picky. So we get here out of these rocks? Nada! But we will blow up that champion and get something out of this kill. Telepills! Ooh, not sure if I want to use those. Could take me very far away from my destination. I actually know where I want to go, so let's not fuck around with that. Sadly, nowhere to spend my money unless I find Judgment or a slot machine. Hey! Actually, let's use a bomb here. And another bomb here, and immediately go fight the boss. It'll save us, like, the entire fucking floor. Oh, you're a sneaky one, ain't ya? We'll blow up here, then, and get out of here. Okay. I can live with that. And then we'll blow up here and waste a key to get in this spot. What are we getting out of this chest? Hey, lots of money. Again, useless, but something at least, I suppose. So much damage! I am one with the gods! Well, let's go fight whoever we got here. Blast Assist! Well, sorry, Blast Assist. But I got a jet. Wow, Meat Boy. Not doing a lot of damage to him. He's taking a while to take out. Might as well just take a couple of pot shots whenever I get the opportunity, but otherwise just sort of split, hang out by these rocks. Well, actually, that was a pretty easy boss fight. We got the Wooden Spoon. Speed up. Not so good, but opportunity to make a trade. Brimstone? The Nail. Tempting. Very tempting. As is 9 hearts, kind of, but, or 9 lives, but we'll just head down to the next level. We are pretty close to the boss, so I'll just bomb my way over there, probably. Oh, hello again, Greed. Twice in the same video? Is that even possible? Well, I guess, obviously, it's possible. Is that allowed? Is that in your code? Again, tons of money that I will never, never be able to use. Can we bomb our way into the arcade? Might be able to get some good stuff there. Sadly, no. We'll bomb our way into the mob trap room. Nope. I guess we'll walk. Oh, great. Envy. My favorite. On the bright side. Ton of rocks in here. Let's explode the shit out of them. Try to get some... Oh! Actually, let's use shears. Alright, you take care of these envies. I'm gonna hang out around the rocks. Maybe get some spirit hearts out of this ordeal. Otherwise, total waste. And the downside is that I've bombed all these rocks, so I have, like, no place to hide anymore. Hammer away. Problem with Meat Boy is that can't hit too many of them quickly. Now the screen is just full of enemies. Whereas I can just spam it and take him out pretty quick. That's alright. What are we getting the mod? Hey, laser. That's not a bad bonus for beating. I don't want to fight the mob trap room on the womb part 2. I'm sorry to say that, but it's the GD truth. Laser's a pain in the ass. Almost always. I am not going the right way to the boss room. We're gonna have to go down this way. Should really use telepills now. Because I am, not really invested in where I am on the map. I'm pretty far away from the boss. Could get closer. Could get the I Am Error room. Bypass this whole fight altogether. Whoa! Let's use them. Whoa! We made it! Alright, so now we get piercing shots. Plus a health upgrade, and we can immediately go down to the next level, bypassing the fight against Mom's heart. And we start in the secret room. I think? a great distance away. I'll need some more money. So we got piercing shots, more health. I can't believe telepills came through in the fucking clutch for me. Now we're gonna go make our way to Satan. Oh, these piercing shots make the zombies so much easier. I've got piercing shots with a wicked amount of damage. There's another spirit heart. I love you. All right, not this shit again. Don't fuck with me, Fallen. Ah! What did I just tell you? I should really use the shears on here, but I want to make sure I have them immediately for that boss fight against Satan. Because anytime you're not using the shears immediately in a boss room, you're wasting your time. The more time that they are active, the better. Okay, that one's gonna die really soon. It's close. Just die. Like, nobody likes you. Thank you. Oh, greed? Really? That ain't right. Now, it would be great to have the Ouija board now so that my shit could actually go through walls, but oh well. Or go through... God, greed! You will not be the end of this Let's Play for me. Fuck me. Greed? It gets decided. Hey, haven't ruined enough of your videos lately. Let's see what I can do. Okay, thanks for the heart, Chubb. Finally, I need it. We got it. Lasers, okay. That's alright. I outwitted it. I don't want your money. I want your life. End it! End its life! Oh man, this is terrible. Two hearts. Fuck it. We'll do it live. Okay, shears are ready. Vomit on a sweater already. Oh no! Mom's spaghetti is nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bomb flies. Am I dating myself with an Eminem reference? I can't tell if he's cool still. I guess that means I'm not cool. I can't tell if he's cool. Oh, fuck. We have no chance here, do we? Absolutely none. It'd be great if this guy could spawn some rocks or something. So that I could just hide on them. Well, if I take out Satan's first form... well, I will not. Still, that was a good run. A quick run as well. Well, I guess we'll go back to Blue Baby next time and see if he can do what Cain can't. Getting so dangerously close over and over. And as always, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time.